Yes, Iorveth, it's time.
Yes, let's go.
Time to finish it.
Whether you like it or not, John Nataris, Temeria will be divided.
For the good of the entire North.
The united forces of Kedwin and Redania will end the fighting among the Elder Houses and secure peace from Gorzvelen to Elendor.
At present, Temeria is starting to resemble the Pontar Valley.
Which, if I understand correctly, is currently controlled by Edain.
You are mistaken, Radovid. Vergen is free.
Free? What precisely does that mean?
Lormark is not Kedwin's, and Edain no longer controls Upper Edain. We have rejected Prince Stennis.
King Stennis?
And handed King Henselt's army a resounding defeat.
Your forces, my dear lass, are nothing but a motley array of rebellious peasants and elven brigands. Sooner or later, they will need to swear allegiance to someone, or they will be defeated and dispersed.
The peoples of the Pontar Valley will swear allegiance to me, Queen Saskia. As an independent realm, we hereby speak in favor of reconstituting the council and conclave.
You're a lovely girl, but you issue from common stock. The sole crown you are worthy of donning is a wreath woven of wildflowers. Redania will recognize no other coronation.
In that case, you must choose King Radovid. Will you carve up Temeria? Or march on the Pontar Valley. Henselt, last of the line of the Unicorns, has sworn to recognize the Pontar Valley as a free realm. Philippa Eilhart witnessed it.
Philippa Eilhart is in my dungeon, awaiting trial for treason.
She was in your dungeon, Radovid, but is no longer. She will sit at my side in Vergen as my royal advisor.
Everything we did in Vergen will be in vain. There's still hope. We have the dagger.
To the matter at hand. The document describing the charter of the Council and the Conclave is, as previously ascertained, an exact copy of the charter found in the ruins on Thaned Island. The more important question relates to the Conclave and its power to designate royal advisors. Today, randomly chosen mages and sorceresses reside at many courts. However, in the time of the previous Conclave, such persons were carefully chosen.
Why shouldn't we pick our own advisors?
These individuals bear great responsibility, Your Majesty. The Conclave needs to be certain they are competent.
And that they will keep the Conclave's interests in mind.
Obviously, sire. The Conclave's chief interest is the well-being and prosperity of the Northern Kingdoms. The document has been signed by every member of the Conclave we have proposed, as well as by all but one of the designated advisors. We await only Sheila de Tansaville's signature.
Without our royal seals, you should be allowed to designate advisors to cowherds at most.
That is true, Your Majesty.
My kings, before you sign this document, please hear me out.
Excellency, with all due respect, this matter does not concern Nilfgaard in the least.
I am here at King Henselt's bidding. Will you deny my right to speak?
What is the meaning of this?
This man tried to kill me this morning. He attempted to take an Imperial envoy's life in your lands.
I presume he was interrogated.
He confessed. Faltest and Demiven died by his hand. He also revealed the identity of his employers.
Sorceresses. They helped me with my assassinations.
Speak on.
The Lodge of Sorceresses sought to remove those rulers who acted against the will of mages.
Lodge of Sorceresses?
We have compiled a list. Philippa Eilhart, Margarita Loantil, Triss Merigold, Kira Metz, Francesca Findaber, Ida Amin, And finally, Sheila de Tanzaville. To my deepest regret, two Nilfgaardian sorceresses, Asirevar Anahid and Fringa Levigo, were also members. The Emperor will deal with them accordingly.
Our queen left to powder her nose.
Your Majesty, what's the meaning of this?
Arrest them all. Your document will have to wait, honorable sorcerers.
You have no right.
Surrender now if you don't want another massacre, this time in Loch Mween. A court of law will reveal the traitors.
We're trapped! I can't get... Sheila! You must get Sheila!
That was a mighty powerful cutscene, all in all. And... Looks that I don't have a choice. I need to fight Saskia. Saskia the dragon. I'm trying to find my way. Know exactly where I need to go. Thinking this way.
Turn back while you can, Witcher.
Don't want to fight you.
You can't dragon. Stop me. Not you. Not anyone else.
Okay, so it was the sorceresses all along. Fighting against. I didn't even know it.
If I have to, I will kill you. How do you like my dragon?
Gwen. What? Gwen. Damn it. And how I'm supposed to fight you? Like that?
Sesenthesis! Kill him now!
You're late. I've already managed to stabilize the portal.
You've got nowhere to run. Sooner or later, somebody will find you.
I prefer to leave on my own terms.
Where's Letho?
Sesenthesis will tend to him, as she will to all the fools who get a hard-on at the mere thought of burning a sorceress at the stake.
Where is he?
I don't know, fool. I've been looking for him since Foltest's assassination. Letho cheated all of us. We were deceived by his dull face and sluggish stare. Don't you understand? The Lodge sought a way to get rid of Demavend, that's true. He was a weak, volatile king. Edirn would eventually choke to death under his rule. We chose the lesser evil. He had to be eliminated, and Letho happened to be at hand.
Foltest? Henselt?
We had nothing to do with that. After assassinating Demavend, Letho used our gold and magical support to find and meet Iorveth. The elf was to help him hide until the matter blew over, or so I thought. The Lodge did not condemn Foltest to die.
Then who did?
Nilfgaard. Letho is the king of liars and emperor of traitors. From the start, he worked for the glory of the great sun and the white flame dancing on the graves of his foes. He lied to everyone. Me, Iorveth, your stupid little Triss, and you.
Got any evidence?
A moment ago, I received a message from the Lodge's agent in Sintra. The Imperial army is on the move. They're fording the Yoruga now. Do you think the North can defend itself in the current situation? And can you count on another miracle at Brenna?
I don't know, but you made it all possible and you'll answer for that. The stigma of treason is yours for all time.
We shall see. For no one will leave this city alive. No one will tell this story. Philippa controls the dragon. As soon as I disappear, it will turn the city into a flaming tomb. We may have lost a battle, but the war is just beginning. You, however, shall not take part in it. This is your end, Witcher.
Farewell! Something's not right! The diamond! Someone replace the diamond! This one's flawed, I'll be torn to bits! Geralt, remove it!
You waited long enough. Should you survive, go south, to Nilfgaard, where you'll find Yennefer of Vengerberg. Farewell, Witcher.
Yennefer of Vengerberg?
Come on!
Wait a moment. Can't I use this? It's no good. What is it? Oh, I need to stab that into heart. It's probably some special situation. Ah, oh, the controls are clunky. And with a kind of instinct decision, I saved Sheila. I saved Sheila's life. Okay, so it's a one-shot game. Sheila's... that megascope was... it was... sabotaged and Sheila was about to die. And I saved her. She gave me the information about Yennefer. Nilfgaard.
Wonder how many more will turn up.
I don't think there will be more, Geralt, luckily. Oh wow, She hits hard. Okay, how about we use this opportunity I have, and actually think about this a bit. First of all, drink some potions. Resistance to incineration, armor. Let's take that. Damage. Swallow. So Virka will give me less effects, but a higher resistance. Then I could finally level up, as I have 3 levels. That will take me to the final level of this game. What will I do? Chance of causing critical effects, more vitality. Let's take that and let's go for the final ability. Giving me some mutated abilities here. Do I have some greater? I guess I will just use these now because I think I'm pretty much at the end of the game, so I might as well. That's one. I'll use a vitality. It's not the best, but it is something. Just in case the game continues, I will save some. There's one, two slots for me to use. Still. Finally. Against the dragon. Open it. Save it. Oh, what? I can't. Oh, man. Don't tell me I need to do that every time. Sign does go to... Oh no, no, Geralt, no, what did you do? How can I mess up the controls like that? I meant to hit Q to cast the Quen sign, and instead I dodged. Oh, I'm not going through the trouble of drinking potions again. Why don't you let me save here, game? Damn this! What the hell? This is stupid. So I should have realized and do all this before. Like, how can I know? The game suddenly doesn't allow me to do this. close. That was hit. Do it, Geralt, do it. No. Bite me, dragon. I mean, don't bite me literally, but die. Get the dagger, Geralt. He's here to hang on. No!
I think we can skip the niceties.
Yeah, unnecessary.
Yet I sense your readiness to fight on.
We were fighting to the death just minutes ago.
I understand. I believe I owe you part of my treasure. Family tradition and all.
No need. Can you make it back to Vergen?
I think so. I've always healed quickly in the past.
Well, that's good.
You know, you're not the first dragon I've talked to.
You met my father, Villain Trettenmirth, known also as Bork Three Jackdaws.
I thought he couldn't have children.
He thought so as well.
Polymorphing. Did you get that from him?
Just a hint of it. I can only assume one human form. He could transform into anyone he liked.
You also don't have his quickness and reflexes. And I don't think I saw a single golden scale on you.
Nor do I have his mustache or paunch. Sorry to disappoint you.
Professional curiosity. Forgive me. Where is Bork these days?
Who can know that? He taught me what he thought I should know and flew off yonder. It's the dragon's way. And he gave me my name.
Sasynthesis, if I heard right.
I prefer being Saskia.
Philippa took advantage of the chaos and escaped. Think she could reveal your secret?
It's nothing I can control. I don't intend to pursue her. We may or may not meet again, but I shall leave that to fate.
She's not one to give up easily. I think she'll come after you again, try to take control. As soon as she's done licking her wounds.
I shall be cautious next time, and I know much more about Eilhart than she would ever wish.
More than she would wish? Interesting.
I obeyed Philippa, but I was not blind. We were close, and Eilhart could not keep all her secrets concealed. I know her weakness, something that can destroy her in an instant.
Valuable and dangerous knowledge.
Precisely why I'll keep it to myself.
Sheila and Philippa have lost. The Lodge has been defeated.
That's good, though temporary. I fear we shall hear of them again.
Mm-hmm. You know Emir's armies have crossed the Yoruga?
I expected as much, as did Philippa. We defeated the Edirnian lords and Henselt. With a bit of luck, we'll defeat the Emperor as well.
Can you tell me what'll happen to Iorveth now?
Let's be honest. He's a terrorist. I'll not lie about him nor whitewash his deeds. He must earn respect on his own, and perhaps, a few generations on, humans will forget.
Did you intend just to use him?
Geralt, Iorveth has killed more humans than you've eaten chickens. He's not one to be used. It's not that simple. He came to believe in me and knew from the start what we were fighting for. He made a choice.
Sure you don't know what I'm talking about? Those baby doe eyes, that intense misty gaze, the pouting.
We shared a cause, fought side by side.
Iorveth did and would do anything for you. Question is, what are you prepared to do for him?
There will always be a place for the Scoia'tael in the Free Pontar Valley. As to Iorveth himself, I've heard many say crude things about us. Thing is, as long as I can remember, I've found dwarves. Fascinating. Must be a dragon thing. And though preferable to a human, an elf would be a compromise.
Time I was on my way.
You shall always be a welcome guest in Vergen. I underline guest.
Don't worry. I'm only ever a visitor.
I know. Sometimes I wish I could see the future, like my father.
And sometimes it's better to be surprised.
Farewell, Witcher.
Handiwork, sire.
In the beginning, there was chaos.
What happened to Saskia?
She's alive. Wounded from our scrap, but alive. She impaled herself on a tree, and then I had to use that dagger. But she'll make it. Mountain air is good for a dragon's hide.
You're the most noble human I know, Gwynblade.
I'm no human.
I'm glad you reminded me. My hatred for the species abated for a moment.
What about Letho?
Strange thing. He sits in the Temerian's former camp. I believe he awaits you.
How do you know?
I saw him. He's got Triss.
Let's go. Tell me what happened here on the way.
While you were fighting Saskia, the city was staged to a bloody spectacle.
The players?
There were many. At first it was a hunt for the traitors, but it soon turned into a hunt for all mages. And there were a few skirmishes between Kedwenni, Redanian, and Temerian troops. Rape, pillage, and murder. Not necessarily in that order. The pastimes of the Order's pious knights. And the regular troops soon followed suit. The kings, with their choice units, left the city just after the dragon attacked.
And the Nilfgaardians?
Remained neutral. That is to say, they shot anyone who dared approach their camp.
Looks like all this turned into a witch hunt. Yes, indeed. Sad sight. And I am to face Letho. Perhaps for the one last time. Right. After the fight, Geralt returned to the city and found Letho. As he climbed the wall, Iorveth offered him a helping hand. The Witcher and the Elf headed to meet Letho. Geralt allowed Sheila the Tensorville to flee, knowing that her deeds would soon be widely known and the sorceress was done for. Geralt ran for Sheila the Tensorville as fast as his legs would carry him. He could hear the sorceress's voice in his head, and the more she said, the more he wanted to silence her. Yet Sheila held one more trump card, the dragon. Geralt spared the dragon's life, or perhaps I should say he spared Saskia, even though the sorceresses may still had a hold on her mind. In any case, it all played out in agreement with the Witcher's code, and it matters little if this code is a fiction or not, which forbids the slaying of sapient beasts. The dragon was not Geralt's true enemy. Unlike Letho, it was him that Geralt had a score to settle. A summit of mages, a stormy sorceress summit, was on in the amphitheater, but real emotions were only beginning. Iorveth awaited Geralt in front of the amphitheater, and the Witcher wondered how its attendees would react to the Scoethal leader's presence. The summit's main subject was Lormark, or rather, the new kingdom formed on those lands and recognized by Erdin and Gardwen. The Nilfgaardians trotted out the captured Kingslayer Letho. The sorceress continued on about recreating the council and the conclave. I regret not being there, for Geralt forgot half of the speeches and misremembered the other half. Yet no one could forget the events that interrupted the summit, for a dragon in all its majesty appeared over the amphitheater. Chaos ruled the bleachers. Guess who had to face the beast? That's right. Fighting Letho. One last thing to do. The epilogue of The Witcher 2. Enhanced edition. Next time.